Hello, everyone. I found something interesting. Being a Jehovah's Witness, we was taught that Christ died on a cross. When Pastor Russell died, when they brought his body in so everybody could look at him, interesting things, what you're going to hear in a few minutes might blow you away. Was Charles T. Russell believed that Christ died on a stake? Or did he believe that Christ died on a cross? Well, to Jehovah's Witnesses, they think that Christ died on a stake. Well, that's what I thought, and that's what I used to believe. Till I started doing some research and finding out the history of what the Watchtower used to put out and information about Pastor Russell when he was died in the casket. And when they were showing the open casket of him in it, what all was there that day? Well, I'm going to play it right now, and we will go from there.
359-360. The Watch directions for funeral. I desire to be buried in the plot of ground owned by our society, in Tim Rosemont United Cemetery, and all the details of arrangements respecting the funeral service I leave in the care of my sister, Mrs. M.M. Land, and her daughters, Alice and May, or such of them as knew why survive me, with the assistance and advice and deoperation of the brethren, as they may request the same. Instead of an ordinary funeral discourse, I request that they arrange to have a number of the brethren, accustomed to public speaking, make a few remarks each, that the service be very simple and inexpensive, and that it be conducted in the Bible House Chapel or any other place that may be considered equally appropriate or more so. My legacy, love, Brooklyn, and why to the dear Bethel family collectively and individually I leave my best wishes, in hoping for them of the Lord is blessing, which maketh rich and a death no sorrow. The published and declared in TTE presence of TIIE witnesses same I extend in a still broader sweep to all the family of the Lord in every place, especially to those rejoicing in the harvest truth. I entreat you all that you continue to progress and to grow in grace, in knowledge, and above all in love, the great fruit of the Spirit in its various diversified forms. I exhort to meekness, not only with the world, but whose names are attached. Mayeth Land, M. Almeida Nation, Lorem, YIOUSE, Donate Allegheny, PA, June 29, 1907. The remains of Pastor Russell, announcement of whose death was published in the last issue of T-Ted Watchtower, arrived in New York from the West on Friday morning, November 10, accompanied by his traveling secretary, Mantis Sturgeon. When body reached Chicago, a large number of friends had assembled at the station, and as it was necessary to transfer the casket from one depot to another, a long procession of automobiles bearing the sorrowing friends formed and followed through the city. The casket was opened during the delay here. HND many took the last look at him whom he knew so well and loved so much. From Chicago the body was AC accompanied by a delegation. Delegations from other cities joined in en route to New York. The remains reached the Bethel home on Saturday, where they were viewed by the family and by members of the congregation. On Sunday morning they were removed to the temple and lay in state until 10 o'clock in the evening. Thus Ann saw them here for the last time, friends crowding the smaller auditorium. All of the addresses, 17 in number, appear in this issue of the Watchtower. The floral display elsewhere in the Watchtower will be found a full page view of the floral display on the rostrum. It was the finest we have ever seen on such an occasion. The scene surpassed description. The rostrum of the temple was so completely occupied by plants, ferns, flowers and a most wonderful collection of appropriate floral designs as to leave barely room enough for the speakers and the remains of our beloved pastor. Moreover, the entire facing of every balcony and box was artistically decorated with a great variety of ferns and flowers. At the foot of the casket was placed a broken pillar of flowers, fittingly representing that dear body which, like the Lord's body, had been broken in the service of the brethren, while at the head was a magnificent floral cross and crown. The cross symbolizing his share in the death of Christ, and the crown symbolizing the crown of glory, which we believe the funeral services all day Saturday and Sunday
Okay, I'm going to stop right there. You see here, Bible students, I was able to get this off their website. And if you look a little bit closer, that's Charles T. Russell, his Bible. And what do we see? The crown and the cross and the wreath. Pastor Russell founder, the Bible students, not Jehovah's Witnesses, which, you know, this is the truth. Because only one portion of the teaching of Bible students, Jehovah's Witnesses kept when Judge Rockefeller took over the Watchtower and changed the name to Jehovah's Witnesses. And that was 1914. That's when they changed everything. Everything that the Bible students teach today, Judge Rockefeller changed it because the rebellion of the Bible students against him. So he changed every doctrine so they wouldn't be acknowledged as Bible students and Jehovah's Witnesses will be having the same teaching. You know how bad that would be? A Bible student coming up to your door talking same as a Jehovah's Witness? Wouldn't that be more confusing to anybody? Don't know why one name is Bible students and the other name is Jehovah's Witness? That's the reason why Judge Rockefeller was smart changing the doctrine of Jehovah's Witnesses. Okay, let's finish it.
Representatives of congregations in many of the cities east of the Mississippi and in He Now Wears with Our Dear Lord in Heaven, Canada arrived on almost every incoming train. The temple, the rostrum, was not large enough to contain all that was inadequate to accommodate them all. The lecture room floral designs, nor was there space available in the interior of below, was open for the overflow. Every inch of available the temple to display all the floral contributions. But how space was occupied from the basement to and including the ever beautiful and numerous all these were, they but very second balcony. Two services had been announced for the temple, one to be held in the afternoon for the friends, the other for the public in the evening. But in view of the rapidly increasing numbers, Tim Committee of Arrangements provided an additional service to be held on Sunday morning. The speaker was Brother McMillan, whose remarks will be found elsewhere imperfectly represented the dignity of love and esteem in which our departed pastor was held by all who knew him well. The Committee of Arrangements were of course desirous of following Brother Russell's suggestion in his will, and to this end requested several brethren to speak at the services. Among these were A.H. McMillan, Mentor Sturgeon, W. E. Van Amberg, P. S. L. Johnson, E. W. V. Kuhn, Toledo, 0. C. A. Wise, Indianapolis, Ind. J. T. D. Piles, W. Shington, D. C. I. I. Margeson, Boston, Mass. F. W. Manton, Toronto, Canada, C. B. Shaw, Columbus, Ohio, G. C. Driscoll, Dayton, Ohio, D. R. L. W. Jones, Chicago, Ill. D. Kilgren, spring. The afternoon service, which had been especially announced for the friends, was opened with a solo, Be Thou Faithful Unto Death. These words were especially impressive, because one of the most beautiful floral designs surrounding the casket bore a broad white ribbon on which were Field, Mass., D.R.A.E. Migosh, Detroit, Mitch, C.J. Wood Tower with one another, to patience with one another and with all men, to gentleness with all, to brotherly kindness, to godliness, to purity. I remind you that all these things are necessary for us, necessary that we may attain the promised kingdom, and that the apostle has assured us that if we do these things we shall never fail, but that so an entrance shall be ministered unto us abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It is my wish that this my last will and testament be published in the issue of the Watchtower following my death. My hope for myself, as for all the dear Israel of God, is that soon we shall meet to part no more, in the first resurrection, in the Master's presence, where there is fullness of joy forevermore. We shall be satisfied when we awaken his likeness, changed from glory unto glory. Signed, C. R. Stazza Russell Worth, Scranton, Pa.
And what you just heard, he mentioned Israel, the Jews. So he believed the Jews were still God's chosen people. So, why would he mention about Israel if he was believing that the Watchtower was God's only channel, not Israel? Why would he go to Jerusalem? Why would he go to the pyramids in Egypt? People, you have to realize Charles T. Russell believed Christ died on a cross. Every information you look up about the Bible students prove that Christ died on a cross. Like I said, can you imagine the Bible students one day coming, knocking on your door, teaching what Charles T. Russell was teaching, and Jehovah Witnesses knocking at the same door with the same teaching as Charles T. Russell? So which group would you join? The Bible students or Jehovah's Witnesses? Of course, you would pick the Bible students because they kept the original name, not Jehovah's Witnesses. So, Judge Rockford had been clever to change all the doctrines from the Bible students to form different doctrine so his group would not be equal or have no part of Charles T. Russell or the original Bible students' teaching. You have a mind, you have a brain. Please use it. And no human leaders. Along as the lines of Rutherford explained, Jehovah's Witnesses could be called neither a sect, a cult, church, or organization. Well, I'm going to let you read it down, but I'm going to come back up here. One, I call them a cult because when you try to leave this religion, finding out there is lies within this organization, which that is what they call an organization. So that's one strike right there. The reason they're called a cult, because if you try to get out of this religion, because you're finding a bunch of lies in their own literature that they publish, and Judge Rockford was the one who predicted the world was going to end in 1925, all the way up to his death, wouldn't that would be considered like a sect, a church? Well, people, you have to realize, when you start doing your research, you'll find out the truth like we all found out. This is a cult. This is nothing but an organization. It's not even a church. It's a big company that's using people to grow in numbers as one big set and cult to make the Watchtower bigger than any religion with the lies, false prophecies, and doctrines keep changing around when time proves that their teaching is wrong, so they're going to have new light to cover up their lies. People, you need to walk away from the sect, this cult, this false church, and this organization. And the name of Jehovah's Witnesses was under a false name of a man who became total control of the Watchtower because he wanted to be filthy rich. Because he was a lawyer, he knew how to twist everything around for the Bible students to become this number one control freak of the Watchtower. Thank you and have a nice day.